Myself, S. Srinivas Reddy, from Srinidhi Teacher Training Institute. So now I'm going to teach you in second year pedagogy of English at primary level. First chapter, issues of teaching English at the elementary stage. So first, I will explain the introduction. Already you know that English is a global language. Because of a globalization, English language transformed into global language. And across the world, we have number of languages. But for the purpose of doing effective communication in business, in agriculture, in education, in every profession, English is going to play an important role. So nowadays, all schools are transforming from Telugu medium into English medium. So there is a lot of demand for teachers to teach English inside the classroom. The problem is that in India, 70 to 80% teachers are not able to teach effectively English inside the classroom. The problem is what? Lack of communicative skills in English. So if we have a communicative skills in English, we can able to teach English language in effective manner. So from long period of time before Britishers and after Britishers, continuously we are using old traditional method, grammar a translation method. Translation method means what? It is a simple translating from Telugu English to Telugu, then we are going to explain, they are going to understand. So it is old and traditional method. But nowadays, in a modern trend of education, this method is not going to play an important role. So we need to change in using of methods, because in India nowadays most of the teachers are using a traditional methods. So in place of traditional methods, if we are able to use a different methods, innovative methods like activity method inside the classroom, students can able to participate actively in teaching learning process of English language. Next point here, in language teaching, listening and speaking is going to play an important role. First listening, then speaking, both are going to take place hand to hand situation, hand in hand situation. After listening only, speaking will go on. After speaking only, listening will go on. So here, for the purpose of getting communicative skills any language, especially in English, listening and speaking is going to play an important role. So listening is one skill, speaking is one skill. Actually in English we have four skills, so those are going to be called as LSRW, means that listening, speaking, reading and writing. So here, as a teacher or as a trainee student, our concentration is on learning the skill of listening and learning the skill of speaking. After getting the skill of listening and speaking, our duty to make the learners use the language in their day-to-day life. So this is the introduction of first chapter, issues of teaching English at the elementary stage. So in this chapter, first one, issues of learning English in a multilingual, multicultural society. So what is meant by multilingual? Multilingual means what? If number of languages will be available in a particular area, so that area is going to be called as a multilingual area. in India, in Telangana, in Asifabad, we have number of languages. Next one, multicultural society. Multicultural means that different caste people, different religion people, different traditional people, if they are going to live together, so that particular society is going to be called as multicultural society. So here, by concentrating on the importance of language, already you know that South Africa, Dakshin Africa President Nelson Mandela, he was given a quotation. So I will read out that quotation. If you talk to a man in a language, he understands. That goes to his head. If you talk to him in his language, that goes to his heart. I will explain this quotation. For example, if I will use my language with students, that whatever information I will give by using my language, that information will goes into the head of the student. If I will use the language of the students while explaining or while teaching any subject, so whatever information I will give, that information will go to the heart of the students. So this is the greatest quotation which is given by the Nelson Mandela. So as a teacher, try to use the language of the students and don't use the language of yours. So here in Indian society, already you know that effective communication is going to play an important role. For the purpose of doing effective communication, for the purpose of getting identity in the society, your communication is going to play an important role. So that communication depends upon what language do you have. So we have number of languages. We have Telugu, we have Marathi, we have a Gurmati, we have Urdu. Number of languages are there. But out of these number of languages, which one is better tool to communicate effectively with the students? That is important. So in teaching learning process, in teaching of English, English is going to play an important role. When you have English, you can able to teach English language in effective manner. You have a English and you have communicative skills in English, then there is a possibility of better interaction between you and students. So for the purpose of better interaction between students and you, what is going to play an important role? The language which you are using in the classroom. The present concentration of teaching English inside the classroom to make them use language in their daily life, especially English. Because in globalization, without having English, you cannot able to go for further education, you cannot able to go for higher education, you cannot go for employment for other state and also other country, because it depends upon English itself only. So across the world, so when you concentrate on the, so how language is using by the people and how much percentage of English is using by the different areas. For example, in English, out of 100%, 75% mails are going to be sent through English itself only. And 50% of scientific journals, 60% of electronic media, means that news channels, use English as their medium of communication. If you go through with TV also, you can understand that how many English news channels will be there, English movie channels will be there. Okay, so in a multilingual country in India, we have 22 major languages were recognized by the Indian Constitution, and more than 350 languages and dialects spoken across the country. So after the formation of linguistic states, our Andhra Pradesh is also one of the linguistic states. Now it is separated as Andhra and Telangana. So, regional-wise, state-wise, area-wise, different languages are there. For the purpose of doing trade, commerce, administration, education, agriculture, health, in every area, English is playing any important role. Next, here we have English. Already you know that we have Hindi. Hindi as a national language, but South Indian people still also, for example, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, they are not accepting Hindi as a national language. Why? The problem is, it is a North Indian language. Because of that reason, South Indian people are not accepting Hindi as a national language. Because of that reason only, in 1965, English is declared as associate official language for indefinite period. Okay, so this is the present position of English in multicultural and also multilingual society. Okay, thank you.